Okay, let's talk about some other positional number systems. To review, both decimal and binary number systems are positional number systems, which means that the value of any digit inside a number depends on its place in the number. So the first 5 in this number, 545, represents 500. The second 5 represents 5. Similarly, in binary, the first 1 represents 4, and the second 1 represents 1. Now, the base of the number system determines how many digits it has and the place values. So, for example, in base 10, decimal, there's 10 digits, and the place values are all powers of 10. In base 2 binary, the digits are 0 and 1, and their place values are all powers of 2, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so forth. Binary numbers are great, but it's hard to read them, especially when they're large. For example, here's 1 million. There must be a better way to represent 1 million. And indeed, there is. One common base that computers use is base 8 numbers, which are called octal. Base 8 numbers have 8 digits, 0 through 7, and their place values are all powers of 8, 1, 8, 64, 5, 12, and so forth. One really nice property of octal numbers is that all of their digits, 0 through 7, can be represented in 3 bits, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. And this gives us a nice way to convert binary into octal. So here's a simple algorithm we can use. Step 1, break the binary number into groups of 3 bits, working right to left. So I've taken 1 million here and broken it into groups of 3 bits, working right to left. The last group on the left has only 2 bits in it. Step 2, simply write the octal digit for the 3-bit under each 3-bit quantity. So this is a 1, this is a 1, this is a 4, this is a 6, this is a 3. And then step 3, just read off that number. So 3641100 is a much more economical way than the binary representation. Another base that's used frequently in computer science is base 16. It has 16 digits, 0 through F. But we use our standard digits for the first 10 digits, and then A through F for 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The place values for hexadecimal numbers are all powers of 16, so 1, 16, 256, and so forth. And base 16 numbers have the nice property that all of their 16 digits can be represented in 4 bits. So they go from 0000 to 1111. And that gives us a similarly nice algorithm for converting binary into hexadecimal. So step 1, break the number up, but this time into groups of 4 bits each. By the way, a 4-bit group is called a nibble. So I've taken 1 million and broken it right to left into groups of 4, and it comes out into 5 groups of 4. Step 2, simply write the hexadecimal digit for each 4-bit nibble. And step 3, read out that number as the hexadecimal equivalent of the binary number. So F4240 is another way to represent 1 million. And the really nice part about hexadecimal and octal is that it's very easy to go in the other direction, to go from hex to binary. To do so, you just have to sort of reverse the algorithm. So write down the hexadecimal number, and under each of its digits, write the 4-bit value for that digit. So F is 1111, 40100, and so forth. And then the resulting number is our original number, 1 million, in binary. Let's finish up this lesson by thinking about abstraction for a moment. We've looked at several number systems. Perhaps you can see an abstract pattern that they all have in common. They're all positional number system, which means that their bases determine the number of digits they have. That also determines the place values, which is simply powers of the base. And then to calculate the value of any digit, you multiply it times its place value, and to calculate the number's value, you add up the digit values. This pattern works for any number system in any base. So for example, the same 4 digits, 1101, written in 4 different number systems. And in each case, we can figure out the value in that number system by multiplying 1 times the value of the place. So 1101 in Decimal is 1 plus 100 plus 1,000. In binary, it's 1 plus 4 plus 8. In octal, 1 plus 64 plus 512. In hex, 1 plus 256 plus 4096. Now, all of these systems, decimal, binary, octal, hex, these are all abstractions, of course. But they're abstractions that have a pattern in common. So that common pattern, which is the positional number system pattern, is even more abstract. Once you know it, you can figure out the values of numbers written in any number system. And to leave you with a challenge, think about the quinary number system, which is base 5, and how would you translate 1101 into its value, assuming that it's written as a base 5 number? We'll leave you with that.